It's basically a very finicky setup of transport rules and HTML. And that HTML isn't really going to allow you to use pictures in it, because the best you can hope for is to refer to an externally hosted picture, which Outlook will by default block. It's overly complex. It was intended for disclaimers and that's it. So we shouldn't be using that for signatures. That's one of the challenges with the transport, with the server-side transport rule, is it's attaching it to the bottom of the email every time. And it's got no real way of recognizing that if this text already exists in there, don't keep adding it. Well, we're seeing with signatures, a lot of people using it as a marketing device. So, over the last few years, all kinds of marketing organizations have been saying, you need to put your Facebook in there, you need to put your YouTube page in there, or your Twitter handle, or your LinkedIn. So a lot of organizations are seeing that, and depending on the type of organization, being able to quite easily change a banner at the bottom. Well, I guess the thing that I look for is, if we pitch this cloud world of any device, then everything must work on any device. So Microsoft has made great strides with Office 365 to make that the case. So I don't want a signature solution that requires me to be either on a domain joined PC or using the Outlook desktop client. I want, if I send an email from my mobile device, if from webmail, my Android tablet, or my PC, to get exactly the same signature experience. That's very important. I've actually known of Exclaimer since about 2006, 2007, when I worked at an SMB IT company. We used to provide it to customers as a great signature solution. I saw Exclaimer Cloud signatures for Office 365, then I went, I can look at this again. Well, I think it makes it incredibly easier to link your social profiles in. The signature designers already have the pre-populated fields, so I don't have to think about it when I design it. And so while customers can use the custom design services, they don't necessarily need to. And what I found the first time I used Exclaimer Cloud was I went in there, applied my color theme, uploaded my logo, put some details in, and I was done in a matter of minutes. And it just blew me away how fast and quick this was and easy to do. Well, most of our customers have actually preferred the simplistic approach, which is, if I'm sending to somebody outside, you need to know who I am, you need to know who my company is, any disclaimer notifications, as well as any links to anything. Internally, I know who you are, I've got the global address list. I don't need to know all this stuff. Yeah, it makes sense, depending on the size of the organization, to have an internal signature, especially if you're talking about an organization that's spread across multiple locations, multiple departments, thousands of people, to actually have that internal signature with relevant information about where you sit physically, who your internal manager is, and those kind of things. When I tell a customer about Exclaimer, I show them how it gives me that consistent experience, and how whenever they get an email from me, it's always the same signature, regardless of what device I'm sending it from. When I'm talking about why they should have Exclaimer, is make that the marketing department's budget. It's not an IT function. IT are providing the service, but marketing actually is controlling the appearance and messaging. And as soon as I say that, they're like, yes, thank you, you've saved me money. It is frighteningly easy. I sat there the first time and I had the entire solution up and running in 15 minutes. So yeah, it's amazing.